All our viewers, you're watching the morning news on CNN News 18. I'm Anjali Pante, here to take you through all the latest news and updates from across the nation and around the world. And we're starting off this bulletin with some breaking news that's coming in. And Storm Raimal has made its landfall between the coasts of Bangladesh and adjoining West Bengal, bringing heavy rains that flooded homes and farmland, leaving a trail of destruction in West Bengal. Now, Raimal flattened fragile dwellings, uprooted trees and knocked down electric poles. So this is the latest update that we're getting, that Storm Raimal has already made its landfall between the coasts of Bangladesh and adjoining West Bengal. Remember, it is expected to cause a lot of destruction in the state of West Bengal, and it has already in fact started. There are heavy rains that have flooded homes and farmland, and there is a trail of destruction in West Bengal. Now, Raimal has flattened fragile dwellings, uprooted trees also, and knocked down electric poles, which is causing a lot of inconvenience to the residents over there. We are showing you these visuals of Cyclone Raimal, and CNN News 18's editor East Kamalika Sen Gupta is now joining us with more details on this. Kamalika, what are the latest updates?
See, the landfall has already taken place. Now it will move northwards in Bangladesh and will weaken. But as an effect of Raimal, we see that there is a continuous rainfall in Kolkata, North 24 Pargana, South 24 Pargana and East Medinipur, causing damage and destruction in various places. Various areas, trees have been uprooted and trees have fallen down. In Kolkata, one person has died because there was like rainfall was going on and he was outside, and then one portion of the building collapsed on him. So it has caused various destruction, but since it is raining continuously, the amount of damage still cannot be gauged, but rainfall is continuing, and specifically the area like Shagor Island, between Shagor Island and Kekupara, this cyclone passed. So there is havoc, destruction. That's what we are coming to know.
And what are the steps being taken by the authorities?
See, there is right now 14 NDRF team working in various parts of South Bengal. Already when the landfall was taking place, they started their work in cutting trees and all. The administration also, or the various ministers, are out on roads, and they are also working. District administration in each and every district, they are also monitoring the situation. Lot of people, more than 1 lakh people, have been taken to rescue centers. So that is also one of the positive points. They expect that there will be less death because of that. But definitely the amount of damage and destruction will be more.
And Kamalika, what is the impact of this cyclone on the flight and train services?
Till today, 9 a.m. in the morning, the flight is closed. The flight operation is suspended. After 9 o'clock, they will see the weather and then they will decide. As far as the train is concerned, local trains have been disrupted, but major mail trains have not been disrupted as of now, but they are running late. On the other hand, we know that the Prime Minister Narendra Modi, he has held a very emergency special meeting yesterday in the evening. We have seen that the Bengal administration also holding in meetings on that, and we have seen each and every district magistrate, they are holding meetings and monitoring the situation. Amit Shah also has tweeted that he has also spoken to officers on ground. NDRF team is working hard. Raj Bhavan has also opened up medical facilities that if somebody requires that. And governor has also called up a special meeting yesterday to review the preparedness for the cyclone.
All right, Kamalika, thank you so much for